She was 18 years old when she met and married the love of her life, Pastor Irwin. And I did see him. He's right back here. Praise God. We had to put that in. They've been married for 39 years. But 38 years ago, they came here to the United States as students and in college. And Praise Center Church was the very first church that they came to. Her husband at that point was not saved. He was, and someday you'll have to listen to his testimony, he was an atheist. He was an atheist, did not believe that there was a God. And he came into church looking pretty rough, you know. He had really long hair, and he sat back like, what are you going to tell me kind of attitude, you know. But look at what God can do. See, I tell you, they keep me on task. So we'll continue with Pastora Gloria's story in a minute. Because I did get off task. Okay. So what I would like to do at this time, before I do introduce Sister Gloria, I would like to introduce our youth team. You know, and then after that, then I'll introduce you. I'm sorry. Thank you guys for letting me be me. We have an amazing youth team, and I am just so proud of our girls. You know, they love the Lord, and they are so excited to be in church and to do things for God. And this is my grandson over here. This is my boogie. And he's worked with the kids, and Pastor Jerry's worked with the kids. And tonight, I just want to show you just a little representation and honor our youth today as to what they're doing. And I'm going to ask Fernanda, one of the young girls in our youth ministry, if she would come up, and she's going to introduce this skit to you.
Hi, everybody. I'm Fernanda. I'm 17 years old, and I'm here to introduce you guys to our skit today. Our skit is called The Bigger Picture, and what that kind of means is, you know, when life hits you with the most unexpected, with anxiety, depression, with all the things that, you know, we face as women, and we can't really say it because we're the strong. We're the strong people. We're the ones who are supposed to be the backbone of our families. We're supposed to want to lead the new generations for whoever. And while these guys are getting ready, I'm going to say just a quick little word. And what really came to my heart today, I was asked to speak yesterday, and I didn't want to think of a script. I didn't want to think of to write something down. I wanted to speak from my heart today. And what came to my heart was to tell you guys, you know, why not today? Why not today? Why not today to go out and to go to the younger generations, whether that be, you know, female, males, you know, that it's the next generation, and make them feel like they are loved, make them feel like they have a purpose, that she is strong, that she is fearless, that she is, you know, she is wonderfully made. You know, she was knitted in your womb. She was knitted and all the amazing things that, you know, could come into her life. And why not today to make those things happen? And I hope you guys just realize that this skit is just to take a step back and just to see the bigger picture. Thank you.
Now the earth.
Was formless and empty.
Darkness was over the surface.
Darkness was over the surface of the deep.
And God said,
"Let
there be light."
Let there be light.
And there was light.
And there was light.
And God said, "Let there be a vault between the waters to separate water from water." God called the vault sky. And God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered to one place, and let dry ground appear." And it was so. God called the dry ground land, and the gathered waters he called seas. Then God said, "Let the land produce vegetation, seed-bearing plants and trees on the land that bear fruit with seed in it, according to their various kinds." And it was so. And God said, "Let there be lights in the vault of the sky, to separate the day from the night, and let them serve as signs to mark sacred times and days and years, and let them be lights in the vault to the sky to give light on earth. And it was so. And God said, let the water be filled with living creatures. Let the birds fly above the earth across the vault of the sky. So God created the great creatures of the sea according to their kinds, and every winged bird according to its kind. And God said, let the land produce living creatures according to their kinds. And it was so. God made the wild animals according to their kinds. Then God said, let us make man in our image, in our likeness. So God created mankind in his own image. God saw all that he had made, and it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. We are the big picture.
And the pain falls like a curtain. All the things I once called certain. And I have to say the words I fear the most. I just don't know. And the questions without answers come and paralyze the dancer. So I stand here on the stage, afraid to move, afraid to fall. Oh, but fall I must on this truth that my life has been formed from the dust. God is God and I'm not. I can only see a part of the picture he's painted. God and I am man, so I'll never understand it all. Oh, only God is God. God, God is God and I am not. I can only see a part of the picture he's painting.
Beautiful, beautiful. Let's give them another hand. Okay. Thank you, young people. I pray that we as older women are painting a good picture for all of you. We're going to just give them a second so that they can clear off the stage, and then we'll just tell your neighbor, those youth are awesome. You know, sometimes we don't look at the big picture. We just see what we see right in front of us. And sometimes that's what we go off of. Just what's happening for the day and what's happening right in front of us. But God has a bigger picture in mind for us. And we've got to keep that bigger picture. We've got to keep that vision before us. Because God has a purpose and plan for every single one of us. You know, it's pretty amazing to see the talents and the abilities that our young people have, and to be able to use them, and not only in schools, not only outside, but even in the church, where they have the opportunity to use their giftings and abilities. Sometimes these young people can just blow you away. I mean, they are just amazing. And you know what? They are looking for someone to follow. And so we need to be that good example. We need to take them under our wing and walk with them. You know, just like Nancy was talking about, mentor them. Mentor them and love them and be patient with them. Because they don't dress like we do, and because they don't act like we do, and they have different thoughts in their mind than we do. But you know what? We were all there one time. And so loving our youth and being patient with them and praying for them more than anything. Because you know what? If we think the devil is after us, I tell you what, I don't want to be a teenager in this society today. Thank you to our young people. That was a blessing. Okay. So let me finish telling you about Pastora Gloria. Pray Center was their first church that they attended, and they were part of Pray Center very faithfully. Their older children, one of them is here, were dedicated as babies, infants at Pray Center, and we're so blessed with their family. They are just such an amazing blessing to us. Well, they moved from Denver. They went to Florida, and they traveled around a couple of places. But after all of that, several years went by, and God called them back to the city of Denver. 7 years ago, they came back to Denver. They said God had spoke to their hearts after speaking with Pastor. God had spoke to their hearts that Denver was their battlefield, and they needed to come back here. So they came back to Denver. They've been pastoring our Spanish congregation for 6 years now. They started out with just the three of them. Now, Isaac is their son, their baby, which she had in her Abraham and Sarah ages. She's really not that old, but and they've got a teenage son at home, and with Gloria and Pastor Irwin and Isaac, they came back to Denver, and they started Centro de Alabanza, and today they have a congregation of about 150 people, and they are doing well. And they are reaching the Spanish-speaking community in our city, and we're just so thankful for them. I'm going to ask Pastora Gloria if she would come, and she's going to introduce their praise team and Danza Alabanza.
I love this woman, I'm telling you. I don't know if I could make it at the age they started, where is Pastor? Right there. No wonder God didn't call me at that age. I don't think I will make it. 6 years at this age, and I'm getting crazy. No, I'm kidding. I love the congregation. Thank God for everybody that been there. One thing that I want to tell you, you know, Michelle told me, but you were just 41 when you have your son. You know, you were not that old. That for the American culture. No, for the Spanish culture. Me at 41, being with all those young girls in the hospital checking me out, they were looking at me like, look at this old woman having a baby. So that's what I said. They called us Sarah and Abraham. And I thank you. You know, I love the pastors. You know, Pastor William was our first pastor, the first church, like Pastora was saying. And I really appreciate it because, honor them. Because if we're not for them, we wouldn't be here. And if we wouldn't be here, those people wouldn't be coming back again to the Lord or saving their life. Those people that are between kids and children and adults, 150. So, you know, we have a lot of children. But I thank God for them, because without them, we wouldn't be here. And we wouldn't accomplish the mission that God gave us many years ago. And he said, go back to Denver. I said, Denver again, Lord? But he said that this is closer to heaven than Florida. So I believe him, and I said, okay, I want to go get closer to heaven. So I came back to Denver in this cold weather. But I'm going to give the girl a sign. You set up right now. We're going to introduce our dancing team, but before they're getting ready, I want my daughter to come here because I want to honor the lady, like Barbara always says, the first lady of the house. I always remember that. And last night was great, sister. Oh, my God, I wanted you to keep going. Keep going. Keep going. I didn't want to go home. You know, I believe in that revival. I believe that that's why God sent us back here. And I always said, the thing that stuck to my spirit was, can you get it? When you gonna get it? You know, when you gonna get that you are the daughters of the Most High God? You don't have to look for love in another place but in Him. Look the kingdom of God first, and everything will fall in the right place. So I get frustrated when women are trying to look for, yes, Daniela, okay, right here. I want to honor you as this is a past, the month of pastoring, you know, appreciation. So I found this beautiful plant. I was going to give you a flower bouquet, but I say they will die. But this one here, I like it because it has three. So this is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So I want you, Daniela, to give it to her. Thank you. Honor your pastors. They pray for you. They look for your life. They spend time praying and advising you. So I love a pastor. Yours, pastor will give it to you. he said, I will give it to him. Don't give it to him. I was going to give it to you today. I said, no, I'll do it. I'll give it to you. So I thank you, Pastora Francine. Thank you for the speakers. It was a refreshing in my spirit last night. I needed it. I needed to hear somebody else preaching to me and feeding me and feel wonderfully fed. So thank you for all your love for all everybody. Todos los que me conocen, lo que ¿quiénes hablan español aquí? Mira, aquí hay una gran cantidad de gente que habla español. Kathy, the move to Florida, you must learn. You learn already? Okay, now un poquito. Okay, chévere. I thank you. The worship team is here. I love them, these guys. I know you have the best, but I say I have the best too. You have the best team of women, I have the best too. So we are all the best, right? Because we all work for the same God, we're in the same boat. But I thank God for my husband too, that, you know, he really loved the Lord, and I thank God for him. And I say, God, keep him alive, because if there is no king, there is no queen. You see, I have to be a king to be a queen. Because he's no king. So keep him alive and healthy. I want to keep preaching. I want to keep pastoring. I love this. That was what I was born for. I was going to be aborted. Look at, and they didn't do it. The first one was aborted, but I wasn't, because God has a purpose. You know, when God has a purpose for you, nobody can kill you. The devil, I said, you have to tell the devil, you know, stop here. I'm the one that said, you know, devil, right here, stop it. You cannot come any farther. No way, Jose. Así que no puede venir más. Vamos a tener una presentación de las niñas de las danzas. This is a dance team. We have about 15, but we don't fit in here. We don't fit there either. We have to go by three. I said, God, give us a big place. But they love to dance, and this presentation is for you guys to enjoy, but I told them, they dance for him. And for him alone. And if you dance for him, then everything will open the heavens and God will bless the congregation. Okay, I leave you with the theme. Telija. That means a word in Psalm that God is in the midst of the worship. Amen. Go ahead.
see the glory of God. We are going to see the glory of God. That's what I chose this song, because we are going to see more than ever we have seen before in any other generation. We're going to see things that, you know, I always said the media won't stop saying the miracles, showing the miracles. Every media, even if they're evil media, because they won't have anything to talk about around the world, because it's going to come a great worship team come up. It's going to be a great revival. It's going to be signs and wonders and miracles all over the world. That's what I understand when I say all the glory we go all over the earth, because it's going to be so much miracles that the media cannot do anything else but show them, because there will not be no bad news but good news, because the people of God are going to rise up and they're going to be powerful. I believe that with all of my heart. That it's going to get a great, great revival around the world. The little tiny village, whatever. Oh, somebody was there for a month and he would rise up. Oh, because it's going to be great things that God is going to do. Amen. So our worship team, I'm going to be right here just because you get a little bit nervous. And she's my daughter, by the way. And I'm glad that my three kids serve the Lord. So thank God for that. All yours, Daniela.
God is good, right? Like they were saying, actually, like the youth was saying, we all have a purpose, and each individual picture had a purpose to make that big picture. We all have a purpose to make that big picture. And sometimes we feel like we don't have a purpose, but since the day that God created us, since our womb, since we were in our mother's womb, we were created for a purpose. Everything has a purpose. The oceans, the sky, if it wasn't for gravity, the ocean would probably take all of us out. And that's everything. Even though we can't see gravity, we know it's there, because obviously the ocean stops where it needs to stop. And sometimes you think people don't see you, or you think that you don't have that purpose, but that purpose is there. And that's what I wanted to let you guys know. If you guys can stand up and let's worship God. We glorify your name, Jesus. We lift your name on high, Lord. Father, let it be you in this place and not us. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Let it rain in this place today. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Oh, te adoramos a ti, Señor. Haz llover, Jesús. open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. We worship you, Lord. Awesome and mighty is our God. He is powerful. Grande y fuerte es nuestro Dios. we worship you, El Shaddai. We worship you, El Shaddai. Close your eyes, open your heart, let the Holy Spirit in. There's nothing more precious than the Holy Spirit. It's not by power, not by might, but by His Holy Spirit that we do things. Oh, we worship you. The word says that he has angels singing, holy, holy. Sing with me one more time. Holy, holy, you are God. Lift your voice. Holy
are you, God.
Let the heavens hear.
Holy are you, God. Holy, holy,
you are God. You are God. Santo, Santo eres tú, mi Dios. Santo eres tú, mi Dios. Santo, Santo, tú eres Dios. Tú eres Dios. Tú eres Dios. There's nothing in life that can satisfy us more than Jesus can. He's the only thing that we need, nothing else. I'm caught up in your presence. I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never want to leave. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't know me. More than anything that you can do, I just want you. I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry when I've come with my agenda. I'm sorry when I forgot that you're enough. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. Estando en tu presencia, oh Jesús, solo quiero estar a tus pies, cautivado por tu santidad. No me quiero ir. No vengo a pedirte, oh no, no, Jesús, no me debes nada y más de lo que puedo.
te quiero a ti. I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you, Jesus. I'm sorry when I've come with my agenda. I'm sorry when I forgot that you're enough. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you, and nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. All we need is you, Jesus. I'm caught up in your presence. I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never want to leave your sweet Lord. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Oh, no, no. Jesus, you don't know me anything. And more than anything that you can do, I just want you. Tell him I just want you, Lord. I just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you, nothing else, nothing else, nothing else will do. I just want you. Nothing else. In the larana de Diasoayasai. Roshambranda larabakiriasai. Give him a praise from your spirit, from everything from you. Say, God, we love you. We don't need anything else but your presence. We don't need anything else but you, but Jesus. Thank you for all the blessings, but we don't deserve them. We just want you, Jesus, in this place. Nada más, Señor, pero a ti. Roshamay, la 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 rara ya so así brocha bra quebra la rara mandria so brocha y brona la rara mandro so y brocha branda la rara mandra y we la rara manda la rara ya la rara macho cria sa y a la brocha brande le rima sobra la rara y oh Lord, we love you. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. Roshamrai. He's worthy. You are worthy, Lord, of all the praises. You are worthy, Lord, of all the praises. You are worthy. You are worthy, my Lord, we love you.
Tú eres santo, Señor.
Nothing praise, we tell you we love you, Lord. The bright fragrance comes up to your throne, Lord. La fragancia santa se eleva a ti, Señor. Una fragancia de adoración a ti, mi Rey. You are my King. You are my King, my King, my King. Oh, Jesus, we love you so much. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. Holy Ghost, we love you. We love your presence. We love you, Lord. Giving a hand, applause up to him. He is worthy. He is worthy of your praise. He is worthy of your worship. He is worthy. He's our God. Thank you, Jesus. A well-dressed woman is ready for battle, right? A well-dressed woman is ready for battle. We are battling the enemy for our family and for everything. Let's give praise and give an applause to him. A hymn to him, only him. Sea la gloria, sea el honor, sea la honra por los siglos de los siglos. Amén. Diga un amén duro. Diga amén, Señor. Say amén, Jesus. Gloria a ti, Jesús. Te adoramos. Gloria a ti, Jesús. Do you feel the presence? Oh, God, since this morning, we've been feeling the presence since last night. Oh, I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful to be here. Oh, my God, you have to do this again the next year. I don't know, next year, because this is a blessing for me, you know. I needed this. Oh, my God, I think I'm the one that's getting more blessed than any one of you. Gloria a ti, Jesús.
Thank God for his presence. He is so good. There's nothing like being in the presence of God. You know, this whole part of this service here, I tell you the vision that the Lord gave me as I'm watching these young girls dancing. Do you see the little one over here? Just, you know what? My heart is just so blessed because this just brought to my mind when a conquering king would march ride into the city. The women and the children would come out and they would dance before the king. They would celebrate the victory that had been won. And they would sing and they would shout and they would dance to give honor to the king. This is just a trial run, ladies. That, you know, we can dance before our King. He is the conqueror. He is the mighty God. He is our Prince of Peace. He is the one who gives us the power to overcome. Oh, we serve a good God. We serve a good God. I'm going to ask Pastor Irwin, you want to come on up here? I just want to introduce you to our pastor. That's okay. Pastor Irwin, Pastora Gloria, and their daughter Daniela. And you know what I would like for us to do? We need to pray one for another. Amen. I want us to just Daniela, if you can just sing that portion of that song, Holy, Holy. You know, as the king would march in or ride in and into the city, he would usually come in on a white stallion, on a white horse. And one day, our king, the King of Kings, will be riding in on a white horse. The victory has already been won. We will bow at his feet, and we will lay our crowns at his feet. I want us to sing that portion of that song. Go ahead.
Holy are you, God. Holy are you, God. Holy, you are God.
holy. Sing to him.
Sing to you, him. God. Holy. Holy.
Lift up your voice.
You
and
are
sing.
God.
Holy, holy.
You are God.
Sing holy.
Santo.
Pastor William, they're requesting you.
Don't leave me alone, Pastor.
I am Sister Francine's husband. I learned that from Sister Nancy.
I guess this is a good time. Let's just pray. Father, we just want to thank you.
Lord,
as we come together as the body of Christ, we come together as laborers together. We want to thank you for calling us, for choosing us. To work together for the kingdom of God. We pray, Father, that there would be an even greater anointing, a greater unity, a greater power in this community, Lord, that would tear down strongholds, that would set the captive free. Oh, God, we need you. And, Father, I thank you that you are raising up a new generation who are willing and desirous to work for you, Lord. Father, we thank you. We give you all of the glory today, Lord. You alone are God. You alone deserve all of the honor and the respect and the glory. To you alone. Oh, we thank you. And Lord, we await the day when we truly will see you with our eyes. Lord, as you come in and as our conquering king, and the enemy is subdued under your foot. Oh, we give you glory. We give you glory. We give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
So you're my king.
Let's give Centro De Alabanza, Danza Alabanza, thanks. Thank you so much. There's nothing I can say right now that God is good. And I know you're just basking in his presence. I'm going to just give you like a 5-minute break to just go and refresh yourself and